convert into positive sign. Now children, please listen and understand here. You can see I had not talked about the integers here, but I had discussed about the signs, and that two negative signs immediately together. You can see this is a positive number, 3 is a positive number, but between 3 and minus 5 again I am having a subtraction sign. So now if I am having two signs immediately together, see in between these two signs, can you see any integer? No. So this, that it can be said that these two signs are immediately together. So this is a rule, when the two signs comes together immediately, that will convert into plus sign, that will convert into positive sign. So 3 is already a positive number, write it as it is. Minus minus comes together, so it will convert into plus. So now this minus 5 will get converted into plus 5, because this sign, that is of what 5 is having minus sign, and this sign when it comes together it converts into plus. So this positive negative 5 will convert into positive 5. Now 3 plus 5 when you add, the answer is 8. Right? I hope this is clear. Okay, now here, check it out in example number B. The first number is having a negative sign, so this is negative integer minus 5. Two subtraction signs are together and then I have minus 10, means negative integer again. But as these two minus signs are immediately together, I am not following with this. This will remain as it is. What we have written up will be carried down exactly what I have written here, that is minus 5. The only change will take place is this, when two minus signs are together, immediately that will convert into plus, and this negative 10 will convert into positive 10. Again, coming on to the former rule, that when one integer is negative and another is positive, in between the integers we have to perform what? Subtraction. So 10 minus 5, your answer will be 5. But out of 10 and 5, which integer is bigger? What of this 10? And 10 is having a sign of positive, that is plus before the 10. So this number will remain 5 as 10 is bigger and it is a positive number. So answer will also be in a positive integer 5. Okay, now coming on to the third change in the sum. Example C of rule number 3, minus 10. Keep it as it is minus 10, it will be no change there. Minus and minus will convert into plus, because this two negative integers, two negative signs will convert into plus sign, and this minus 3 will get converted into positive 3. So this 10 minus 10 is going to remain the same, write it as it is. The change will take, minus minus will become plus, negative 3 will become positive 3. Now again minus 10 and plus 3, right? In front of 10 I have minus, that is negative sign. Front of 3 I have positive sign. So 10 is negative, 3 is positive. So 1 is negative and positive, always the subtraction will take place. So from 10 you subtract 3. What will be your answer? 7. But here, check out the digits. Which is bigger, 10 or 3? Forget the signs and check only the numbers. Which is bigger out of 10 and 3? What always 10 is bigger? But 10 is having a sign of minus, so the answer will be in minus integer only. Hopefully this is clear to you. And this is the rule which is very easy. You know, when two positive integers are added with positive sign, the answer will be definitely a positive integer. Now when 3 and 7 are added, we are not having any of the numbers in a negative sign, with a negative sign, so definitely both the numbers will be added and the answer is also positive integer. Again with 5 and 3, we do not have any negative integer or negative sign in before the number. So both the numbers will be added and the answer will be in a positive integer compulsory. Okay, from all these rules, I come on to the new topic to be explained, addition of integers on number line. Now just check out the two examples. Here 3 is positive, in between plus, we have to go with addition. So in between these two integers, that is one is positive and negative, we have to perform addition. Now as I said, when two signs are together, plus and minus, always the plus will be removed and it will be, the sign of minus will take place of plus. So 3 is going to remain as it is, plus minus, plus will be removed and minus will come. So 3 minus 1 is equal to 2. Okay, now remember this very first number is a number from where we start subtracting or addition of the integers. So this will be our starting point. You can see this is our starting point, right? So I had made a line from 3. Now after 3 I am having which integer, negative or positive? Negative. So negative integer always moves towards left and positive integer always moves towards right. Now here I have to go negative minus 1. So I have to move towards left side because negative integers comes on left side of a number line and positive integers comes on right side of a number line. So I am here having 3, that will be my starting point on the number line. See, this is a line on which I have shown the numbers. So this is a number line. My starting point is 3, from where I am going to start my calculation. 3, and then I am having a negative integer minus 1, so I have to move on to the left side. Out of 3, when you subtract 1, the answer will be 2. So only one digit you have to count on number line, 3, and after that, before that it comes 2. So 3, I have count only one digit towards the left as it is minus, so my answer is 2, right? But before performing on the number line, if you calculate orally, in a way what I had done, that will be more easier to calculate answer on a number line. Second example is minus 7 plus 3. Now see, the first integer from where I am going to start with my number line is minus 7. So 0 you have to compulsorily show on a number line without fail. Here I have taken 0, I have taken just one positive integer, that is 1. I had moved negative integer still 7 because the 7 minus 7 is the starting point of my number line. So I had taken this first line on minus 7. Now after minus 7, the number is plus or minus, the number is with positive sign. This 3 is with a positive sign. So again I go with the rule that one is negative integer and one is positive, you always go with the subtraction. So 7 minus 3, it will be 4. But out of again 7 and 3, which number is bigger? 7. But as 7 is having a minus sign before it, the answer will be in negative integer. But here, 7 is a starting point. After that, I have positive 3. So whenever we have positive numbers, we always move towards right of the number line. So I will move towards right. But how many I have to move? I have to move 3 here. 3 here. Previously, I moved only 1 towards left. So my answer is 2. Now here I will move plus 3, that is towards right, 3 integers I will count from minus 7. So minus 6, minus 5 and minus 4. So I move towards right plus 3, that is positive integer. So my answer is minus 4. Hopefully this is clear to you and it will help us to solve exercise 6.2. I end here for today's lecture. Thank you.